Hey friends, Frankie here in Casper's Kitchen, where we cook music. And today I'm going to demo my cigar box guitar that I built several years back while living in Dallas. I watched a video several years ago by Justin Johnson called Cranking Up the Shovel. This gentleman is, besides being a great guitar player, he builds guitars out of ironing boards, skateboards, cigar boxes, you name it. And he was quite influential in me jumping into the plunge here. Like most of you, I knew nothing about building a guitar. I didn't know anything about woodworking. I just said, you know, go for it. Simply put, I made a lot of mistakes and it was very stressful. But I ended up with an okay product. The first thing I did is I went out on the internet and did some searching. I thought, you know, I'm an idiot and there's got to be a kit out there that'll make me look good, something that I can put together simple. And they were. There were a lot of great kits out there, but they were all for 3-string and 4-string guitars. And I didn't want to reinvent learning the guitar. I wanted a 6-string. And I also was very much into 24 frets. I had to have a 24 fret neck. I wanted some really blasting pickups. I wanted a real attractive box and some nice hardware, something that would be a high-end guitar, if you will. I collect guitars, have a lot of nice guitars, so I didn't want a piece of crap. I wanted something that would play as good as some of my 30-year-old collectibles, and I ended up with that. The first thing I did was went on eBay and went shopping. I bought a 24 fret neck. This particular one had just a slight little extension that allowed me to glue a block plate on it that extends all the way to the back. It gave me some support for my strap lock, and it also added some sustain. Found this beautiful jewelry box in Poland. All this gold you see is actually brass wire. Somebody bent it and zigzagged it and hammered it in all around all the circles and curves and triangles is wire. It's a very labor intensive. It was made in the 1930s and I picked it up for about $40. Found these knobs with the little bird inlays that match my neck on eBay for about $25 each, and it was a long time before I decided to actually buy them. Used Zach Wild EMG pickups, 81s and 85s. So this is a Goth 510 bridge. Spurl Zigs tuners, if I'm saying that right. They're locking tuners. I had this custom-made nameplate with my name on it just for bragging rights. And all in all, I ended up with a very attractive-looking guitar. And it's a 24 fret. I can get right down to the 24th fret, blasting pickups, and it ended up being exactly what I wanted. Now, I did make a lot of mistakes. I had to reset the neck at least 4 times, maybe more. I spent $750. It took me 3 weeks, and while I was doing it, I had a heart attack. But I ended up with the final results of something that I was quite proud of. I played it for a few years. When I retired, I sold my house. My wife and I moved to North Carolina. My family's here, and my son, who's also a guitar player, and he does part-time Lutheran work, after he played it for a few months, he said, "Hey, Dad, let me reset that neck for you." And I said, "Go for it," you know. And he reset it, and he filed the frets down, and he's got it just perfect, and it plays like butter. And while he was doing that, I asked him to switch these Zach Wild pickups around, put the 81 in the front and 85 in the back. I had read online that really give a nice balance. And one of the issues I was having with this guitar is I couldn't do pickup changes in the song because the back pickup was so much louder than the front that if I went from one to the other, I had a volume boost or volume decrease. And so I just, you know, played either or. But I told him to switch them around. I said, you know, we'll just see what they sound like. And that was the best move I made. It really made a major difference, give it a perfect volume balance. And I'm really pleased with it. Let me just show you what I mean. I'm in the neck pickup right now. See, that's just a tone change. Now that gives you a lot of versatility if you want to play a little folk music. The middle pickup, I honestly don't use on most guitars. It's just not one of my favorite positions, but on this one, it's really a sweet sound that I kind of like, particularly for blues. If I'm playing, you know, maybe a little blues intro. Nice and sweet, and then the neck, it's that sound that everybody that plays metal or rock wants. It's that cutting sound that you're looking for. If I'm wanting to really cut through the bass and the drums. And then if you want to get a little dirty, just throw on some distortion. You know, get that metal face. All right, friends, go out and build you a guitar. Buy you a kit, do whatever, have some fun. Do your research. Hey, if you like my video, subscribe to my site and give me a thumbs up. And again, thanks for watching, and you have a great day.